has a voice you probably won't forget. Why? Well, he's the man behind Marvel's infamous Black Panther. And now voice artist James Mathis is here in studio to talk to me about his new projects and what's next. Stay tuned.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin.
District and genius is weak of fiction. King of the fighters, king of the fathers, king of the lady, king of the answer, king of the problem.
Good song choice. All right, guys. Well, welcome back, After Buzzers, to a mini spotlight. I am your host, Morgan Willett, and I am so excited. In honor of Comic-Con, I have a very amazing guest. I have voice artist James Mathis here with me. James, how's it going?
Everything's great. Thank you. Thank you for having me, Morgan.
Of course. Well, okay, we've got so much to talk about because, I mean, we've got a lot. You are the voice behind Black Panther. First, everyone needs to know that.
T'Challa, yes.
That is so amazing. And we have to talk about Marvel's Avengers Black Panther's Quest. It's coming out this fall. That's what everyone is talking about. Can you give me any scoop on that?
Oh, yeah. Marvel's Avengers Black Panther's Quest is the fifth season of the Marvel's Avengers Assemble franchise. The first four did not focus on Black Panther, and this one is called Black Panther's Quest. It's going to follow Panther and his sister Shuri on their episodes in Wakanda.
Amazing. Yeah. Have you heard any feedback from fans? Is everyone excited? Has there been a lot of hype so far?
Yes. Just before Comic-Con, Marvel released a little teaser trailer for the series.
I did see that.
And it's been well received by the fans. People are really, really hungry for this Black Panther series.
And then you said just before this, they dropped the movie poster, right?
Yes.
So that's exciting.
The show art is now available. It's up on all the sites. It's everywhere right now. It's great. It's really fantastic art. All of the animators, the artists on the series, they're phenomenally talented people.
Amazing. Yeah. When you said you're going to San Diego Comic-Con,
yes,
leave tomorrow.
Yes.
What can we expect from you there for everyone who's listening who will be there?
Yes. We will be part of the Marvel Animation Panel, which happens, it's annual, and it's on Sunday. And they're going to preview the show. They might show an episode.
Ooh.
I'm not sure if they're going to show a full episode. But myself and Daisy Lightfoot, who plays Shuri, are going to be on the panel along with the showrunners. And we're going to give a little bit of tease for the show.
Okay, guys. So everyone, if you aren't going to Comic-Con, now you really should.
You really should.
You should. That's so exciting.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, I have a question. How did this role come about? Because I feel like this is so huge, especially now that the movie's out, everyone's talking Black Panther.
Yeah.
How did this come about?
This came about, I originally played the role about 5 or 6 years ago in the first iteration of Avengers animation. And then it came up a few years ago in advance of Panther's appearance cinematically. And it, just like another audition, you know, I got the material, I laid mine down, and thankfully it went my way.
I'm so curious how you, because I know acting and all that, I'm assuming auditions, we get that.
Right.
How do you prep for a voiceover?
Well, you have to be mindful of your limitations.
Mm-hmm.
Hand gestures and those things like that don't really serve me very
right.
well. So to prepare for it, I guess you just kind of have to close your eyes, you know, find the embodiment of the character. And really focus on those key traits. I think that's the best way I found to prepare.
So when you try and embody Black Panther, what's going through your mind? Do you like try to channel being a superhero?
Yeah, well, you know, before that though, I want to channel being a king. Because that is T'Challa's primary responsibility, and that is king of his people. And beyond that, I focused on certain core attributes of his, which are that he's an intellectual. I really wanted to focus on that aspect of him. It's important for black heroes, brown heroes, all heroes of color to have qualities that the youth can look up to. And I think an intellectual is something that that kids can aspire to be. And that's something I wanted to focus on.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Well, have you had a lot of fans come up to you?
I have. Thankfully, this all summer, I've been doing the con circuit. So I went to Chicago. I was in Florida. I'll be in North Carolina.
Okay.
And it's great. That's really, I would say, the cherry on top. It's meeting the fans, especially the young ones. And a lot of them come in their costumes. And so it's beautiful. I have a son. He's 7 years old, and I have a daughter who's 8. And
oh, I bet they love the fact that their dad is Black Panther.
Yeah, I think they do. I think they do. It's a great time in their lives for me to have this role, and I really appreciate the interaction with the fans, because they're responsible for the success of the show, mm-hmm. and it's a wonderful exchange. You know, it's I appreciate them probably more so than they appreciate me.
Yeah. And have you ever had any? Because I'm envisioning fans, all sorts of stories. Has there any been like one story with a fan that really stands out above the rest?
Yeah, I think one person actually asked me if they could handcuff me.
Oh.
Which I thought was interesting.
Was there a reasoning behind this?
Well, no.
All right, they just wanted to handcuff you.
I mean,
okay.
I can't speak for anyone else.
All right.
But it was a meet and greet, and she came with her handcuffs. And
did you let her?
No.
Okay. You never know. She might not have a key. You might just be stuck.
Exactly. Well, they were fuzzy handcuffs, thankfully.
Oh. So, okay.
Yeah, but I didn't want to go down that road.
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
I had to stay in my lane and just mind the throne.
All right. Well, so you got all sorts of fans, I see.
Yeah, all sorts, for all ages, shapes, and sizes.
Yeah.
It's great.
Well, okay, let's rewind a bit, because I know before you went into doing this and voiceover work, you were an actor.
Yes.
So on camera.
Yes.
What do you enjoy more? Do you like being behind the scenes voicing, or do you enjoy more on camera work?
I would have to say the cop out answer is that I enjoy both.
Oh, okay.
I enjoy
Understandable.
Them equally. I think each has its own je ne sais quoi.
Okay.
I think for voice acting, I appreciate the challenge of primarily using my voice to convey emotion. And I think on camera lends itself to obviously more physical characterizations and real life portrayals in that way. And I appreciate them both. I started on stage, so the live aspect of it is appealing to me.
Mm-hmm.
But the voice work it's an amazing experience. There are lots of really, really talented actors who are also voice actors. And at its core, it's acting. Now, people think just because you have a great voice that you can be a voice actor,
mm-hmm.
and it's still voice acting, you know, and I appreciate the ensemble within voice acting. We record our animated series as a group, almost like theater in the round. And so we run the pages consecutively with our director, Colette Sunderman. She's amazing. And it's kind of like live theater in that way.
Interesting. Yeah, see, I just thought it'd be like one person, you do your lines, right. And you leave. So no, it's everyone together.
For series, for video games and other voice jobs, you are alone.
Okay.
You are alone. And that has its own challenges, because you're oftentimes in a scene with someone and you only have your lines. You're not playing off.
Right.
Of,
I feel like it'd
someone.
Be easier with a group.
Yes. In some cases,
you get to play off each other.
It's live. Yeah. The scenes can really come to life, because you have that energy between you. And when you're alone, you don't have that. And you have to rely on your preparation as an actor and the tools that you bring with you to the job.
So for Black Panther's Quest, how long? I'm curious.
Mm-hmm.
For an episode, and
yes.
your voice acting, I know nothing about this. How long does it take for an episode with everyone?
Each episode
record.
Each episode is recorded in 4-hour sessions.
Oh. Okay.
So we have what I like to call Wakanda Wednesdays.
I love it, Wakanda Wednesdays.
Yeah, we record on Wednesdays from 2 to 6, and it's a great time. You know, it's a great time. Sometimes we're done sooner.
Okay.
You know, just because everyone's prepared. You know, and we can really get through it, and it's playtime. You know, I mean, it's work, but it's play at the same time.
Yeah, it sounds fun.
It's amazingly fun. It's amazingly fun.
When did you realize in life that you had this voice that, I mean, you can make a career from?
Probably when I got this job.
Oh, okay.
No, I think when I was younger, I did all of the disguising of my voice initially on the phone with relatives.
I bet you're great at prank calling.
It was fun. It was fun. I think the Jerky Boys were around once upon a time ago, and they were big on voices and prank calling. So I would hone my skills there, and also at drive-thrus, because they can't see you at the drive-thru. So you can pretty much be whoever you want to be until you have to pay for your food. Yeah, so
is there one voice besides the Black Panther voice? Is there one that you like to do a lot, like an accent or something like that?
Sure. Every now and then I like to talk to my friends in this manner, because they don't expect it. They don't know who it is. And you talk to other people and you say, how are you? It's good to see you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night.
I'm dead. I'm dead. Yes. I would never expect that voice to come from you. I love it.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
It's so fun. Well, before we wrap, is there anything you want to tell the fans for Comic-Con? Anything else you're working on that you want to get out there?
Absolutely. I would love to tell the fans to check out Black Panther's Quest on Disney XD. It premieres this fall. It's a continuation of the Marvel Avengers Assemble series, and it is going to be something to see. There's no animated series like it. There's never been one like it on TV. And it's, yeah, you got to look out for it.
Do we have a month yet, or we just know fall? I'm trying to get the deets here.
I believe unofficially September 23rd.
Ooh. Okay, guys, you heard it here, September 23rd.
That's right. Yeah.
You heard it from James. Well, James, before we wrap, where can everyone find you on social media to catch up with everything that you're doing?
You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at James Mathis III. That's James Mathis III. You can also find me on Facebook at James Mathis III Fan.
Love it. Well, James, thank you so much for joining us. I can't wait for September.
Yes.
I'm going to hear the voice. I know the man behind Black Panther now.
Wakanda forever.
There you go. Well, thank you so much.
Thank
you guys for tuning in. I am your host, Morgan Willett. You can catch up with me on social media at Morgan_Willett. And until next time, we will see you later.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.